10 celebs who don't know a thing about food.
Whether it's burning things, cutting my fingers, cooking isn't my forte.
Are being taught to cook by one of the world's best chefs.
My name is Giorgio Locatelli. I believe I can teach anyone to cook. All I have to do is to light that passion.
In Giorgio's last class...
I shouldn't have taken on pizza. Oh!
It's raw and also somehow still burnt.
Nancy and Scotty T struggled under pressure.
Something went wrong in ingredients.
I need to get this on now, quick.
Scotty, in the oven, now.
Our Geordie hunk left crab show in his pasta.
I went through the whole thing.
An Italian Nancy murdered a national classic.
The dessert was the worst I ever seen.
Which was enough to send them both packing.
Group hug, guys, group hug. Come on, man.
Our drag queen champion Blue rose to the occasion.
You really impressed me.
Being named Giorgio top of the class for the second time.
I'm starting to become a patisserie chef.
But to have a taste of victory... All the celebs have to do in this competition...
Close the oven!
...is prove they're not the worst cooking class.
Shockingly bad, it's a disaster.
Nestled within the rolling hills of Wiltshire, our six remaining celebs are ready and raring to go for another day of their culinary crash course.
Look at me, top of the class again. I think it's time for you to be bottom.
Oh! It's a new day at Celeb Cooking School, and I know that all eyes are on me because there are two blues in those photo frames, and I love it.
I feel as though every time I've been very close.
You are all not pulling it out of the bag enough.
It's my second day now with the red apron, and you know what? I'm gonna get top of the class.
So today is the day. There is no way it's going to be Ruth or Blue again.
Raise your hand if you think Arj is the worst in the class.
Fine. I started off badly, but I feel like I'm getting better. Do you not feel like Giorgio sees potential in me?
I think today's your day.
You are hanging on by a thread.
No one believes in me. No one sees me as a threat. But do you know what? I'm going to prove these people wrong, and it's going to feel so incredible when I do it.
Today, let's smash it, and hopefully Arj won't be here tomorrow. Yeah!
Out to school these class clowns is Michelin-starred maestro Giorgio Locatelli.
For a couple of people, it could definitely be time up today. There is people that really need to impress me if they want to stay in the school.
Morning, students, gather round.
Sure, Danny, coming through. Coming through.
Hi, Lou.
I love Louis. He is exactly what I want to be whenever I'm much, much, much older.
Welcome on another day on my cooking school.
Timing is everything when it comes to cooking.
If you don't get better at keeping track of time, you will never become good cooks. And there is no food that demonstrates this better than pasta. Pasta can go from being perfectly cooked to a soggy mess within seconds.
This morning, Giorgio will be teaching students how to make an ingredient extremely close to an Italian's heart. Fresh pasta. Once they've made their dough, they need to use their creativity to make their own pasta dish.
For an Italian, it's like them. It's mum and pasta, that's it. That's the most important thing. Okay, students, listen very carefully.
The students must try and keep up with Giorgio as he teaches them how to make the dough. Good luck.
Boom, 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 boom. Let's go.
It's simple, right? Flour, salt, and olive oil.
Olive oil! Olive oil!
Oh,
that so... looks like olive oil to you, Louis.
Then it's in with two whole eggs and a yolk.
I always get shell in it.
And then with a spoon, you start to break them.
Mine looks like...
He's trying to get me to make fresh pasta, and I've never even boiled spaghetti.
Mine's very lumpy. Looks like brains.
Who makes their own pasta? What I didn't realise is it's only eggs and flour. So it's actually not that hard. Well, he made it look easy. We'll see.
Oh, jump your phone! Come on! Please!
Arj on his phone, I mean, honestly, he gets very distracted. He's capable, but distracted.
OK, come on, gather round. I want to show you something.
Pay attention, donuts, because the master pasta maker is in session. Get rolling, chef.
Okay, so I'm gonna push it loud and again. Back. It's your body then goes down. It's your ass then goes down there. Ah, Louis, you are incredible, you are.
I mean, he was thrusting back and forward with his big bit of wood. I was like, really? There's no need for that at this time in the morning.
Chef, why is your pin so big?
Are you on the same team with Louis as well? If you're not out of breath and you're not sweating during this, then it means you're not doing it right. Okay? What I want to see from you at the end is this.
Translucent. Yeah.
Let's go.
Demo done and dusted, it's dough time for our six pasta noodles. Needing a win, reality star Arj is working hard on his dough. Opposite rap star Nadia.
Oh, God, you look like you're fighting with it, man. It's just a little bit of pasta. It's not like, you know, look, like that. We see, this hand stays like that. His hand turns it in.
Yeah.
All the time.
Now, push and stretch. Oh, man. Push and stretch.
Finding his own rhythm, Dance Supremo Louis needs no encouragement.
Darling, I mean, I don't know about push and stretch. What about the bend and snap?
The bend and snap.
This is my first time getting to work with Louis. I feel like we're in a gay disco over in this corner. It's just fabulous.
It's like a Saturday night out for us.
Push it.
Yeah.
Looking to lose his red apron, spuzzy shine, roof stoble, he means business.
What are you doing in this side?
Just trying to help, chef.
No, that's perfect, shaking his one.
Oh.
That's really good.
Spots did it.
His spot did it for you?
Well, he helped. He showed me how to do it.
All right, that's good. Very good, Spud. You're a very good teacher.
So far, so good. I'm seeing good signs. In fact, I really think I've got this.
Spread for me. Spread for me.
Right in that.
Anyone else sweating?
We just glow.
I'm drenched. Yours is dead, Arch.
Have I found my speciality?
Say goodbye to that red apron. Nah.
I still want to be here. I've got lots of enthusiasm for this, and if anyone's going to teach me how to make the perfect pasta, it's going to be Giorgio himself.
With the pasta rolled, Giorgio explains what's in store for the celebs next.
I want you to make me a beautiful pasta dish. I will be judging your dish on its flavour, your creativity, and, of course, the presentation. Timing is everything.
At the end of today, the student with the least promise will be leaving cooking school. You have 60 minutes. Your time starts now.
By now, these lot should know a carrot from a courgette. As for pasta perfection, they may need help to get their creative juices flowing.
I don't know what the hell I'm gonna do.
I'm gonna make ravioli.
My dish is going to be a pumpkin ravioli.
What does a pumpkin look like?
At Halloween, you see them cut the eyes out of it, yeah.
Okay, cool, so what does that look like? Right, I don't know what a pumpkin is, so I'm just gonna use butternut squash. I'm gonna do a butternut squash ravioli.
I think I'm gonna go for the thing with meatballs.
Well, my game plan is just to make a lasagna, because who doesn't like a lasagna?
You're gonna cook a whole chicken?
No, I'm gonna fillet a chicken.
Guan root.
Guan root. Bird in the hand, Roof, isn't pulling any punches with her restaurant-inspired classic.
Roof, what are you doing?
I think it's pasta. Parmigiano. Do you know they're like, it's like chicken fillet with stuff on it.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
Good job, me.
Wait, but how do we cut the pasta?
Still in the pantry, Blue is struggling to get started on her dish.
For a lasagna, though, I want something square, right? Or do you cut it like this? Do I build that in a tin? So hard. I truly do not feel good about this dish. I think I should have paid more attention to Giorgio and less attention to me and Louis playing with our wood.
Argy bargy, you've gone for the penne pasta.
Penne arrabbiata.
I think
it's not even on the recipe
it's
list.
It's not even there, but it's impressive.
We're at this stage of the competition where I feel like you've got to take risks.
Well, you kind of have
can't
to.
Can't play it safe anymore.
You've been bottom of the class three times now, Arj. So you got to go for gold.
I know exactly what it needs to taste like. But whether I get it to taste how I want it to, that's another question.
I've actually got you a little present to inspire you.
Go on.
I've got you a chef hat.
Must try.
Look at that.
Working opposite Blue, Louis leaping ahead with his dish. Tagliatelle with a guanciale and tomato sauce.
I do feel a pressure. I feel like Louis is doing very well today.
No, I'm not, honestly. I don't mind cooking food like this because there's not so much going on.
I have been surviving on cooking only the desserts. I'm a little bit nervous about it, if I'm honest. Do not get too confident in what you're doing. Always strive for the best. This is my kitchen. Basically, I don't frequent it very much. There's my scepter for winning RuPaul's Drag Race UK. Did I mention that? In school, I was the goody two-shoes, A stars across the board. I was head boy, a librarian on the school council. So believe me, when it comes to being a goody two-shoes, that's me. I'm starting again because the sauce is just too runny and I just would rather just not put as much milk in and then just let it thicken easier. I don't know what I'm doing, to be honest, but you'll soon find out.
I think that I have made the wrong decision trying to make lasagna. There are so many ingredients and so many things that you have to do that it's just going to be impossible for me to even serve anything.
Are you struggling, Nadia?
Oh.
What are you chopping up there?
Garlic.
Any spare?
Love a bit of garlic. Any spare? Yeah, thank you.
Thanks. Got any spare onions?
Nadia.
We share. Me and Arj
share. All your stuff.
We've got a good relationship.
What did Arj get from the pantry? It's like he went over there, did a twirl, came back and asked me for all my stuff.
Garlic, olive oil, onion, chilli, tomato. Done.
Oh, he was very full of himself today. He literally thought he was Giorgio, like a telly.
I'm quite laid back because everything's going really well.
Bang, bang, bang.
Fellow bottom of the class Spuds is determined to impress this lesson with his butternut squash ravioli.
That's done. Next thing, next thing, next thing, next thing. Time is of the essence. Oh, yeah.
Wait, why am I about with the pasta? Oh, I need to get my sauce on.
I've already made the pasta. How hard can it be to shape it? I worked in prosthetics when I was younger, so I'm quite good at, like, sculpting.
Now, Arj, to help you grasp your timings, I want you to do the next time check, all right? Right now.
What do you mean?
Now, 30 minutes is done. 30 minutes to go. I want you to shout it out.
OK.
All right?
All right. 30 minutes to go!
30 minutes?
Hurry up.
Hurry up!
Good, Arj. Well done.
Come over here. Potatoes should be done. Ba-ba-bow! Oh, snap!
What is going on here? I've burnt the plastic tray!
Mate, you can't put plastic in the oven, even I know that. No, he can't eat that, man.
You don't put plastic in an oven. He was gonna use the bits of butternut squash covered in melted plastic. I mean, I'm not a great chef, but I'm not that bad.
My life is falling apart.
At Giorgio Locatelli's Celeb Cooking School,
15 minutes left. Come on, cooks.
The students are desperate to impress with their fresh pasta dish.
That's getting better now.
I feel like if you just put tons of cheese into everything, it's like we're groovy.
But dropping himself in the danger zone, Spuds has seasoned his butternut squash.
Spuds, what have you done?
With toxic plastic.
Busted.
Spuds, you melted the thing. Come here, 1 minute, show me. What's this? You put the plastic tray inside that.
I didn't know it was plastic, chef.
That is a complete disaster, isn't it? You cannot use that. No. No, you can't.
He looks so disappointed.
You cooked them on top of that?
There was some on top.
I won't eat it. So you have to think about a new stuffing. You have to start the feeding all over again. Come on!
And Spuds isn't the only one against the clock.
Quick Stitch, you're making lasagna. It's meant to go in the oven. It's not going to work, even with the fresh pasta.
It'll be fine.
How long has it got to go in the oven for?
20 to 30 minutes.
Yeah. She's been so consistent and top of the class twice, I think she has further to fall.
Feels good, baby.
That is not great. I really thought that was going to taste gorgeous.
5 minutes left!
5 minutes!
Yes, students, yeah. 5 minutes left.
Smaller they are, quicker they're going to cook, I reckon.
This is what I'll do. I'll do something mad quick. Hold on. I'm never a quitter, guys. I don't quit. Ding! Brain flash. Oysters. Right. I've got a new plan. I'm going to put the oysters in the ravioli. Oyster ravioli! Initiative, 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 initiative. Initiative, initiative, initiative. Beat the eggs.
1 minute left. You need to start plating up.
Spuds. There.
You are the best. You are the best.
Do I look like somebody who likes someone cook pasta?
I'm going for it. I'm going for it.
Get it out now.
Wow.
Please, please, please.
Oh my. Wow.
10 seconds left.
Is this chicken cooked?
Oh no.
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. That's fine.
5, 4, 3, 2. One, time's up! Step away from your plate. That's it.
That looks amazing. I'll have to have a look.
This might be Arch crawling, graveling his way up to the top.
It is amazing. I can't believe I made it from scratch. Giorgio may as well take this apron off now and give me a white one, because I'm smashing it today.
Oh, it went absolutely terrible. That does not look like a lasagna that I've ever eaten, but I have confidence that someone's done worse than me.
It's time for Chef to taste your dishes and give you some honest feedback. Spuds, you're up first.
Spuds is serving his reversioned, reimagined ravioli dish.
This is a oyster ravioli with tomato garnish, pecorino cheese inside.
Pecorino cheese.
Pecorino cheese.
Pecorino.
Pecorino.
Ri.
Li.
Ri.
I haven't got that sort of tongue, chef. I can't do that, chef.
Oh. It doesn't come at all. It's a pecorino. That's right. And these are your oyster?
Yes. What's funny?
Mussels.
Those are mussels, they're not oyster.
Oh. I didn't know, chef.
He looks a bit like a murderer. This is a mess, this dish. Yeah. You made a really nice pasta as well.
Seriously?
Yeah. Mussels are very strong as a flavour. Pecorino is very strong as a flavour as well. To put them together is a little bit difficult. Some of the parts of this dish are actually good. Some of the parts are terrible.
I had an absolute mare. I can try and bring it back in the afternoon, and I will bring it back in the afternoon, because I need to stay in celeb cooking school.
Next, it's Arj, who's cooked a penne arrabbiata, which is penne with a spicy tomato sauce.
The plate is presented very well.
I saw the way you presented something previously and I wanted to emulate that.
I appreciate that. Mmm. Very spicy.
Yeah.
The making of the pasta was good. The cooking is okay, it's not overcooked. And the presentation is okay. I think you've done a very good job.
Thank you.
Bravo, Arj.
I don't think anyone can believe that Arj has cooked something decent. Let's hope he doesn't get too cocky.
Don't write me out. I told you this morning.
All right, pipe down.
I'm being serious. It was a big mistake. And now he's laughing.
Arj, there's still another challenge to do later.
Oh, I'm looking forward to seeing your dish.
Well, now you can, Arj, as next up, it's Blue's lasagna.
I must say the look is not as inviting as it's supposed to be. What went wrong?
I think the dish was quite complicated. There was a lot that had to be done and then a lot of time to cook in the oven, and I just didn't anticipate that. But I did experiment with my flavours, so I hope it at least tastes good.
The quality of the pasta is good. The bechamel is good. It's really a shame that the presentation let you down.
This is easily the worst thing I have cooked in this kitchen.
Louise made tagliatelle with a guanciale and tomato sauce.
It's very simple.
It is simple.
He's got this beautiful decoration.
Yeah.
That's something that you could get in any restaurant in England.
Oh.
It's a very simple plate of pasta. You execute it really well. You plate it very well. If you go home to your Latino husband and you cook him this one, it'll be very happy.
It's a good night.
Well done, Lee.
Ruth, you're up, please.
Filleting Queen Ruth is serving penne with chicken parmigiana, generously covered in melted mozzarella.
I must admit that the making of your penne is exemplary. Look at that. Chicken is cooked properly. Okay, let's taste it. Ruth, I'm very proud of the fact that I can see that the skill that I teach you, you are using them.
Yeah.
So, butchering the chicken for me, that's, you know, it's almost like you're saying to me, I'm listening to you. And really, it is delicious.
Wow. Wow.
I'm so chuffed with that. It'd be nice as well to, like, go home and be able to make it for my parents.
Oh, bang on. Love that for you, girl.
Nadia, you're up.
Nadia!
Nadia has made a ricotta and courgette ravioli with meatballs.
You make these beautiful ravioli. They are absolutely, like, look, these are restaurant standard.
Thank you.
OK, let's taste it. Look, you've done a really good job with the pasta.
Thank you.
Which was really the most important thing, a very nice stuffing as well. And on top of that, you really did well with the timing today. But very good effort.
I can smell top of the class. It's, like... it's right there.
So, Chef, we know that pasta is very personal to you. How did our class do today?
I must say, I am very proud of them. But don't sit back, because this afternoon we got two more dishes and they are killers.
In Wiltshire...
Sorry, guys, I'm just farting up the place, you know?
What?
Yeah.
I don't think...
I do apologise, yeah.
Giorgio Locatelli also has the wind in his sails for the second cookery class of the day.
Today, I'm going to teach you two dishes. Both these dishes will again teach you the importance of timing and turn simple cooking into an art form.
Like every afternoon, Chef will demonstrate two courses for his class to copy perfectly. For the main, a vegetarian Italian classic, stuffed courgette flour with a roasted pepper sauce.
Courgette flour is a beautiful vessel. Is a transformation skill to turn something so beautiful into something crispy to eat.
And for dessert, a luxurious mango ice cream sandwiched between two golden brandy snaps and accompanied by a delicate passion fruit curd. Giorgio starts by making ricotta filling for the courgette flour.
Full fat milk, the lemon juice, is quite important to stir it. Slowly the curds appear. Can you see the curds?
Yeah.
Okay.
I didn't even know you could make cheese. I thought, like, dairies did that.
Giorgio stuffs his flour with the ricotta.
Pump.
Dips in batter, then fries for 3 minutes.
The courgette flour was so delicate. Honestly, it was like he was caressing the head of a newborn baby.
Blended to perfection, the bed for the baby's head is a roasted pepper puree.
So here, I make some romesco sauce. That's what I want from you.
Anything on the side, G?
I prepare also some roasted peppers.
More peppers? Right.
Now the courgette flour and my mayo. A tiny little bit of almonds, and that's it. Dessert today is my take on a childhood classic, the ice cream sandwich.
Ooh.
Time is of essence in this.
For his mango ice cream, Chef blends frozen mango, then adds cream and condensed milk.
That is ready.
And places the mix into ice cold molds.
This goes in the freezer.
When I get my ice cream, I eat it straight out of the tub. Nobody ain't got time to be mashing, blending, pulling in the freezer.
Do you want to taste a bit of ice cream?
Yes, please, Chef.
I could see that you were wondering that. Let's go to the Brandy Snaps now.
Brandy Snaps are delicately thin biscuits made by melting butter, sugar and syrup together, then by adding flour, some ginger powder and lemon juice.
And I'm gonna spread it out on the tray. These goes in the oven for 15 minutes, 180 degrees.
When cooled, chef cuts out the snap circles. And now for the tricky passion fruit curd. Mess this up and you'll have scrambled egg on your face.
Yeah, that's it. Then if he's not like mine, he has to be better than mine. I push them apart every day. But what do they come in here, for holiday?
Remember, at the end of this lesson, one of you will be going home.
Halfway through the course, it's time to shake up the team dynamics.
Arj and Spuds, because you've both been bottom of the class more than once, you get to decide who you're paired up with.
The Red Apron Boys, the Disaster Boys.
I would like to go with Louis.
Okay.
Oh. I mean, Louis is a loose cannon as it is, and Arj can't cook, so what are they going to do?
And Spuds.
The person I would like to pair up with is... Roof.
Knew it.
Ooh. And that, of course, leaves Blue and Nadia.
It's a good team.
Yeah.
You have 80 minutes. Your time starts... now!
You want to do...
I don't know, you're head chef, so...
No, don't make me head chef. I was head chef last time. Take some responsibility.
In that case, I believe my best way of putting out some magic is by doing a dessert.
All right, fine.
Head chef Arj, who would have thought it? I'm the boss. Follow my lead.
I'll get on with my job, and you've got to get on with your job, but you are also leading the cook.
All right, let's crack on. Frozen mango chunks, they're in the freezer.
Yeah. Why are you asking me? You're the head chef.
No, 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 come on, Lou.
He decided to be head chef, and then every 2 minutes he's asked me to do this, to do that, and I had a lot to get on with.
Paired by fate...
What do you want to do?
...are Nadia and Blue.
You've had more successes with desserts. I've had more successes with mains. So I think it's not the time to play safe. Let's switcheroo.
I'm gonna trust her, but I just hope it doesn't trip me up.
I'm so
happy to be paired with you, and I think we're gonna slay this.
I think so too.
She was quick off the mark with that one.
But hoping slow and steady wins the race is Spuds, who, after a disastrous morning...
What is inside here?
..is looking to land a stellar dessert.
Big stone in the middle.
Is it? Ah.
Should you have peeled it first, do you think?
Yeah.
That mango should have been frozen. You're doing the puree. We got frozen bits of mango, look. Where's the frozen bits?
You got frozen mango?
In the freezer. There's frozen mango in the freezer. You're doing the puree. You don't use fresh mango. I'm just a bit professional babysitter at this point. Yeah, you blitz that up.
I am here to learn to cook.
I'm like a crab. I feel like a crab.
But I will be billing E4 for childcare.
And bearing the brunt of her babysitting is the ricotta mix.
Well, the milk is boiled. Milk is... yeah. Milk is really boiled.
Oh, my God.
To ensure the students stay on track, I've come up with an amplified solution.
59 minutes and 32 seconds left.
I like that. I like that.
It's helpful, isn't it?
It gives me trust in you.
You're welcome, Louis.
Why are you putting it? Put it in the molds.
No, but because it's not going to fit like that. Trust me. It'll be like this. Trust me. This is going to be better than Giorgio's.
Spuds is like, do you know, like that jack in a box?
Come on in, you want some diving header?
that, like, doesn't ever stop.
Who are ya? Who are ya? Who are ya?
In school, I had different stages. So in the beginning, I was really quiet because I used to get bullied. But then what I had to do was become a little bit of a joker. So I started becoming funny. Then my bullies became my friends. My attention span is very small. And that's just because of social media. Like, I'm just everywhere. Like, you're talking to me now. You know what, I don't even, yeah, you're right. What are you saying? Yeah, you call me. Fine, I'm just gonna.
That's not a plastic tray, is it?
No, this is definitely ceramic. It's fine, isn't it?
I'm currently making the herb mayonnaise. I'm just trying to get it to the consistency that Chef asked for.
Blue, Nadia, you're going down! You're going downtown!
That spuds, it was getting right on my nerves. I wanted to make a spud snap and just...
See, this is what happens with you boys. You get too confident and mouthy.
That's true, we do.
Shut up.
You're true.
And cook that.
Yeah, sort your own stuff out first before you come for us.
See, I'm spending all this time doing this.
Sorry, Louis. 40 minutes gone, 40 minutes left. The sands of time are slipping.
Do you know how long I've been whisking that? 5 minutes.
My bad, Louis.
So next thing I'll do is the brandy snaps, yeah? I don't want to go home. I have potential to be top of class today, but I need to have a good dish now.
And also needing a good dish to stay out of elimination is Blue, who's prepping her peppers for her romesco sauce.
I don't know if that's right. I've never roasted anything before. That's why I'm on this show.
My peppers are cooked, they smell good, but I cannot get this skin off and it's gonna hold me back.
I'm gonna put these in for another few minutes. I'm gonna tell you this right now. I'm not gonna have anything to serve, I don't think.
What do you mean, babe?
I'm gonna try my best, but I just don't know. I don't feel like I'm doing very well.
Mine's a lot thicker than Giorgio's. Brandy.
Arch in the oven. Come on, get it in the oven now. 50 minutes, now.
Could I have spread that better?
That's fine, just get it in
the
oven.
You sure, Luke?
Absolutely.
You got it in the oven?
Yeah.
Are they in? 180?
180.
Look at the clock. 15 minutes from now.
15.
15 minutes, come on. And then you're going to cut it. What are you missing now?
Now I need to do the sauce.
What? Half an hour left.
How is it half an hour left? Bloody hell.
I'm never going to get this finished.
No, babe, don't say that. We've got this, we've got this.
I'm sorry, Louis.
Get him, Louis. Get him.
Whoop his ass, Lou. Whoop his ass.
How do you toast almonds?
I don't have a clue. Does it say it in the book?
No.
Seeing Blue under that kind of pressure and seeing it actually get to her, that was new. Blue might be cracking.
Hold on, hold on. Everyone stop what they're doing. Everyone stop.
Doing my head
I'm
in.
I'm done. I've done everything I needed to do.
I don't care. Spud, shut up.
You shut up.
You shut up.
You shut up.
I've finished. Look at me. I've finished, everyone.
Is that helpful? No.
Oh, wait. Diced pineapples. I am not done. I am not done. I need to do diced pineapples.
They're mangoes.
On what planet does a mango look like anything like, or taste anything like a pineapple?
And Spuds' confusion is beginning to spread in class.
Oh, see, this is when I get overwhelmed. I don't know, because there's too many things to do.
Relax. It doesn't have to be perfect. As long as you get a
nice... No, but there won't be nothing.
As long as you get a nice standard dish on a plate.
Yeah, but it won't happen. I forgot to put my tomato in the oven along with my peppers.
I can smell burning here somewhere.
Yeah, it's Arj is burning. It might be his.
Arj, what are you doing?
Oh,
yo!
Hell no! What's happened, Arj?
Losing track of timings, Arj's brandy snaps are beyond burnt.
He's only losing his head! He's only losing his head!
Arj, what have you done?
No. Oh, I would have done so well.
Look at this disaster you made there. Are you going to start the new one?
Chef, I can't start a new one.
My heart is broken. I've got smoke in my face. My dessert is ruined. I just don't need it. Now is not the time.
Archie's gonna be home.
I just don't know if I could possibly be saved.
Back in the heat of the kitchen classroom.
5 minutes left.
Ah!
I've really screwed up this time, Louis.
Our six celeb students are on the final lap of their toughest cook yet.
I wonder how bad it will taste.
There is something else I've forgotten. There was another colour.
So the last 5 minutes, absolutely hectic, because there's me still trying to get my sauces done. And Arch burnt his brandy snaps. It was mayhem, it was panic.
Oh, I know it was. It was the pepper.
Too late to roast his own, Louis on the scrounge.
You got any pepper you're not using, darling?
Take one, just take a whole one.
Because you only need two.
And remember that, Louis, darling, whenever I ask for dance lessons.
Even Surefire Blue is struggling with the finer touches.
Another thing I can't use. I'm not gonna have anything to serve. I should have just done the dessert like I wanted to.
Crushed garlic vinegar.
Students,
oil,
you have just 3 minutes left. Just 3 minutes left.
Just chaos.
Okay, I'll help.
Oh my god! We're doing okay for time.
Where's the curd? Which one's the curd?
Passion fruit curd, it's here.
That's the curd. Okay.
Yeah, and this is the mango slices.
Okay.
There's the lemon zest.
You do know if curd is meant to be thick, right? Like right. It's not meant to look like soup. What is that? It's like a scene out of Alien.
Curd is not meant to float around a plate like frog spawn. It was horrible.
Argy, where are you?
Let me know when there's 30 seconds left, please, Chef.
Are you gonna come back and play these digs, or are you just gonna hide there behind the freezer all evening?
Wait, pause.
1 minute left!
My version of dices.
You happy?
You happy? It's your dish.
I know, but are you happy with what we've done?
It's terrible.
Ah. Time's up! Time is up! Please step away from your plates.
Blue.
This is the worst time I've ever had in this class.
The brandy snap. I burnt it. If only I got it out of the oven sooner.
It's time for Giorgio to taste your dishes and give you some feedback. Louis and Arj, you're up. Louis, Arj, who's done what?
So, Louis took control of the main. I have taken control of the dessert. And I was also head chef.
Who made you a chef?
It was an agreement me and Louis came to. Can I say something controversial? Well, you said to me, take it out at 20 past five.
You say my fault?
No.
Is it my fault?
No, but I...
Is it my fault?
Listen, I'll accept it.
What do you mean I accept it? You made it. What do you mean I accept it?
I know, I'll take full responsibility for it.
Don't you dare blame me for that.
Sorry, chef. I don't know, my head's all over the place.
But you did blame him, and you even said to me on the table, he's really told me and now he's messed it up and look what he's done to me.
Louis, come on.
What is this supposed to be?
Passion fruit.
Curd.
Passion fruit turd.
Curd.
Curd, not turd. Passion fruit turd.
That was with such sincerity that you so meant that.
Okay, look. Look, Arj. This is not funny at all. Arj, this is not funny. Look, this is uneatable. I can barely look at it. And that one, I'm scared to. What is this?
It's melted as well because he was on the phone to somebody and he left it on the side.
Louis, seriously?
I am.
Arj, that's why you burnt it. Because you were on a phone, mm-hmm. Not because of me. Ice cream is nice.
Thank you.
Okay, let's go to your dish, Louis. These, by looking at it, they are
Somebody else peppers, isn't it?
Yes. My sister Blue gave
them to
me.
Why didn't you use your own peppers?
Because I did not put enough peppers in the oven.
Well fried, still nice and croquant, and the stuffing is pleasant. Overall, you two.
It's a poor effort.
You are all talk and no action, both of you.
Mm.
Louis completely threw me under the bus. I don't know what got into him.
Come on, get back to your place.
I'm just hoping my pasta can keep me in this competition.
Quite frankly, his brandy snaps were burnt because he wasn't paying attention.
Blue and Nadia, you're up.
Blue, Nadia, who did what?
Nadia normally does mains and I normally do desserts.
Mm-hmm.
So this time we thought we would switch it up, for better or for worse.
Let's start with the presentation. There's all these little dots of black. Why do you think so?
Maybe my burnt almonds.
Oh, the burnt almonds in it.
But
that's why then there's these burnt almonds there.
I don't know, like,
yeah,
I don't...
But why you serve it to me, you know, something like that? Don't put them on, no? Ooh.
No, that's not a good...
The ricotta is a little bit soft and is missing a little bit of flavour. And the pepper sauce is a little bit behind in salt as well. Really missing salt. Okay, Nadia's dessert. The passion fruit curd is there. It's a little bit soft. It should keep a little bit more, but I'm gonna taste it. I found the biscuit a little bit too thick. Should have been a little bit thinner. The ice cream is very good, done very well. And I like the curd. Overall, this is not disappointing, Nadia.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, look, Nadia Blue, dessert, I quite like it. There is a lot of mistake in the main. Let's go.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm, of course, super disappointed with my feedback from Giorgio, and if I have the chance to cook again, I will put my best heel forward.
Spuds, Ruth, tell me. Who's done what?
Well, I did the main and Spuds did the dessert.
Mmm. Okay, let's have a look. The flour is good, it's very well cooked. You're very close with the flavor. Overall, the look is not satisfying, but flavors-wise, it's quite close to my one. Spuds, what is this?
That's
this is supposed to be the curd.
That's supposed to be the curd.
Mm. Unfortunately, you know, I won't be able to taste it because it means the eggs is not cooked in there. So if I eat these, I'll be feel sick tomorrow. Okay? But I'm gonna taste the ice cream. The quality of the ice cream is there, but I can't get over this sauce. Why did you put it on? Just serve the ice cream. Just take it away.
I don't even know what curd is. Is it a drizzle? Or a sauce? What type of liquid is it? What's the consistency? I don't know.
It's now decision time for Giorgio.
Okay, chef, let's start with the hot spot everyone's hoping for. Top of the class. Who really stood out today?
Today, my top of class is... Nadia.
Yes!
Giorgio.
Thank you very much. That means a lot to me.
Top of the class, where I belong.
This is where I'm staying now, honey.
Your ravioli today, they were restaurant standard. And your ice cream was very, very good tonight. Plus, you were the only person to make me a reasonable curd.
Now let's move on to the tough part.
Who really struggled today and is your bottom of the class?
Arch. Spuds. Blue.
And yeah.
Arch, you did impress me this morning with your pasta. But then, you served me a biscuit that was burnt and tried to blame me. Spuds, you were very chaotic this morning. It showed in the end result. Your curd tonight was raw and unsafe to eat. I admire your fighting spirit. But here we are again. Blue, the presentation today let you really down. I was very disappointed with that dish. The student I'm sending home today is... Spuds.
I'm devastated about Spuds going. Despite him being so loud and annoying, he truly was a light in this kitchen.
Smashed it, bro. Well done, man.
I just hope everyone smashes it, do well, focus, don't panic like how I did, and whoever wins, give me some of your winnings because I need some.
We love you, Spuds.
Spuds is chaos in the kitchen. He ruined my oven. I love his enthusiasm, but his time is up.
Sayonara.